Lumos. Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was
Revelio.
Before I invented flu powder.
This looks intriguing. Alohomora.
Revelio. 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 Confringo. Compulsa. Lumos.
What do you have in store for me this time?
Revelio. Accio.
Lumos.
Revelio.
Lumos.
Pulso. Lumos.
So tricky after all, Merlin.
Revelio. Confringo! Kendo! Glacis! Compulso! Revelio. Revelio.
Revelio.
I know what that means. Merlin trial.
Revelio. Revelio. Kunfrigo.
What's that? Settled.
Revelio.
Abandoned long ago, no doubt.
Revelio.
Hogsfield. Now where to find Mrs. Sprottle? Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this.
I remember you. Your generosity helped me afford this rather exotic snake contraption.
Revelio.
Ranrock's loyalists are a menace. What can be done?
I couldn't help but overhear. Did you mention Ranrock's loyalists?
I did. Never imagined they'd act this deadly. I'm Claire Beaumont, by the way.
Nice to meet you.
Ranrock and his followers have set up camp here. No regard for our beloved hamlet or our livelihoods. Ruthless. My brother Bardolf dared to stand up to them and ended up in St. Mungo's. I'm simply at my wit's end.
How did your brother Bardolf end up in St. Mungo's?
Bardolf had spent the entire day handpicking herbs and roots for us. When a group of Ranrock's lot appeared and demanded the harvest for themselves, Bardolf refused. In their anger, they hurled him against a rock and robbed him. The moment he left St. Mungo's, he vowed revenge. I worry he may be dabbling in magic that he will one day regret.
You said Ranrock's loyalists have set up camp here. Where, precisely?
To the south, across the river. Last I heard, there were several loyalists in each camp. I won't go near them.
Why don't you simply leave the area for now?
Upper Hogsfield is my home. Bardolf and I grew up here. No, we are standing firm. Once my brother returns, then we shall decide what to do next. He's gone to seek Victor Rookwood's advice. I didn't approve of that idea, but perhaps in the end it will help.
I'm unfortunately quite familiar with Ranrock's loyalists. Perhaps I can do something.
Much as I would love to be rid of them, I wouldn't want you to risk injury, or worse. Please be cautious. We should not have to live in fear. This is our home.
I'm sure I can handle another enchantment now.
Not saying I don't cast the odd healing spell when no one's looking.
I could go on tour.
Revelio.
It seems as though things are getting worse. Best be on my guard.
Bardo, Ranrock's loyalist.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Seems a pleasant.
Revelio!
I could handle another enchantment now. I could go on.
Revelio.
Who lives here?
You can stop a thief in their tracks, Steve.
Revelio. 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 Revelio.
It's like a place right out of a storybook.
Revelio certainly never revealed the charm of my potion.
Aloha, Mora.
Ramlock's loyalists are not to be underestimated.
Revelio. Revelio.
Mine now, demiguys.
Aloha, Mora.
Revelio. Revelio.
This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Thinks it's got half a chance.
Shane Bardolph thought dark magic was the answer. I reckon Rookwood's played a hand in his disappearance.
Hello, Mrs. Sprottle. Actually, Serona Ryan asked if I'd come and see you.
Oh, dear Serona, a gem. Has been for as long as I've known her.
She thought you might need help collecting ingredients for your Wiggenwell potion.
And she's correct. My darling Aiden used to collect hawklumps for me. Since he died, my supply has dwindled.
I'm sorry for your loss, Mrs. Brottle.
Oh, thank you. Love of my life. A bit lost without him. If you wouldn't mind gathering some hawk lumps for me, I'd be happy to compensate you for your time.
Believe it or not, I have some with me.
Oh, thank you! How wonderful! The travelling vendors will be thrilled to replenish their stock of Wiganweld potion.
Serona also mentioned that Mr. Sprottle was bringing her a box of letters when he fell ill.
Indeed he was. I'd almost forgotten. I stumbled upon it just before Aidan died. He was hoping to go through it with Serona over a butterbeer or two. Those two were always like two bow truckles in a branch. Aidan took ill when he was collecting hawk clumps on his way to see her. He made it home, but I fear he dropped the box in the cavern. The cavern is in the hills just southwest of our hamlet. You can gather hawk clumps and collect the box of letters there.
Serona said she lived with you during the summers when she was at Hogwarts. What was she like?
Oh, goodness. Well, she was almost exactly like she is now. Charming, good head on her shoulders, taking care of everyone. I can't tell you the fun we had when she and her friends would visit us during the year, all buzzing about, practicing charms. Talented group. Her friend Mirabelle was a genius in the garden. Learned it all from her muggle parents, if you can believe it.
Do you remember anything about the letters you put in the box?
Oh, of course. A few letters from some of her school friends. Some nice memories. I even included a letter Serona had written to me when she was staying with us. Thought she might enjoy reading it. I know when I read writing from my youth, I'm always astonished at how much I've changed, and yet remain the same.
Thank you, Mrs. Brottle.
Thank you. I'll be here if you are able to collect those hawk lumps. I, and the vendors I help, would greatly appreciate it.
Revelio.
Bardo Beaumont should have returned by now. Had by dark wizards, he was. Shame Bardo. Magic was the answer. I reckon Rookwood's played a hand in his disappearance. Thank you.
wager I could handle another enchantment now.
Bardolph Beaumont should have returned by now. Had by dark wizards he was.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
These rocks have seen better days.
Betting on the dragon fights was the best decision I've made yet.
This must be the cavern Mrs. Sprottle mentioned.
I'll check your pockets after you...
You're the little son.
There must be some students at Hogwarts that we could recruit.